In this video, I'm going to show you the 5 productivity apps that I use every single day and why you should try them too. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Reagan Rose, and I am trying to get more done for the glory of God. There are a lot of apps I use to stay organized and efficient and just to be productive with my time. But there are only a few that I actually use every single day. And this is that list. I want to show you the 5 apps that every single day of the week I open at some point and use. So this isn't going to be like a super in-depth review or anything. I'm just going to show you each app, its basic features, and how I use them personally, but hopefully give you some ideas for productivity apps you might want to try in your life. So the first app that I use every day is Rome Research. Now, Rome is kind of hard to describe. It's a tool for networked thought is how they describe it. But basically, it's a note-taking app that works a lot more like your brain actually works. And so when you open up Rome each day, you're greeted with the daily note. And in the daily note, you can write whatever you want. Ever you want. Write whatever you want. The real power in Rome is in what's called bi-directional links. And so I can create a link to another page and start writing here too. And the link back to the original block that I wrote, the original page I wrote, is right there. And so what I like about Rome is it allows me to dump all of my thinking, all of my writing into one place, and the connections between my different thoughts and the different things I'm working on grows over time. And so I do my journaling in Rome. I do any kind of writing projects. For example, I'm working on a book right now on video games, and that is all happening in Rome, and all the research is in here, all of the drafts are in here, and I can kind of interlink everything in a very organic way. I use it to sort of keep a running work log. I'll write down what I'm doing. You know, I can say at this time I wrote this. I also can do things where if I have a good idea, I can quickly create a note about that idea and start writing about it in here, and it doesn't distract me from whatever else I'm doing. I can also do to-dos in here. And so it's just a very quick way to, from the keyboard, create items to work on, to create new notes, and interconnect everything that you're working on. What I really like about Rome is that, unlike other note-taking apps, it doesn't require you to slow down and organize and decide where something's gonna go before you actually start working on it. You can kind of dump stuff in here, and the connections to other things within your notebook kind of develop organically over time. In the future, I'm going to be doing a full video on Rome because it has so many features and it's so different from other note-taking software that I think it warrants a deeper explanation. One thing you kind of have to be aware of with Rome is that it is a bit pricey. It's $15 a month, but it is such a powerful tool that is a price I happily pay. Now, the next software that I use every single day is Readwise. Readwise, I've done a complete video on this. I'll link to it up above right here and at the end of the video, but it is a tool that basically aggregates all of the highlights you take in Kindle or services like Instapaper or Pocket or even some podcast players. It'll take any highlights, any notes that you've made, and bring them all together in one place, and it will serve that up to you in a daily digest. So here's the Readwise homepage. It's a really awesome app. They have it for your phone too, but you can also just use it in the browser. And if I jump over to my dashboard, you can see this big button that says Daily Review. This is what I do every single morning. I go in and start my daily review, and it gives me 5 to 6 highlights from books or articles or things that I've read in the past. And it takes my own highlights and shows them to me. So here's something from Walden. And I can star this, or I can add a tag to it, like farming or something if I wanted to. I can keep it, I can discard it. I can do lots of stuff with it. I just like Readwise because all those highlights that I took in the past now get shown to me again, and something that my previous self thought was interesting, my current self is like, oh, that is interesting. Readwise is also great if you're like a student or something who wants to memorize things and kind of commit them to your long-term memory. These different highlights it shows you can be treated like flashcards. There's a whole section on mastery here, which I don't really use because I'm not a student anymore, but you can take those highlights and use this service to commit them to your memory. The thing I do use a ton, though, is I export my notes to Rome and Notion. You can also use Evernote and CSV or just like plain Markdown, but I like to export everything automatically to Rome Research, which we just talked about. And so within Rome, I have this little inbox, and any new highlights I've taken the previous day will show up here. And it doesn't matter if they're Kindle or Instapaper or Air Podcast Player or whatever, I have a full list of new things. So I read this thing called Undone by Indecision. It was a great article in Desiring God. And I went through and I highlighted it. And I even started to take my own notes on it. And all of that is getting sent here using Readwise as the middleman. So I'm in Readwise every day, and it kind of brings together Rome and my Kindle, and also the next app on this list, which is Notion. So the next app on my list is Notion. Now, I also did a whole video on Notion maybe a year and a half ago, but most of the principles are still applicable. I'll link to that above. What I love about Notion is it's just so stinking clean. Look at that. It just looks nice. Rome is kind of the place I dump all my messy thoughts and try to build out my thinking. Notion is where I keep everything organized and tidy, for the most part. I use Notion for my project manager. So whether that's something I'm doing in life, like a project around the house, or mostly for the stuff I'm doing for Redeeming Productivity. So I have this whole content calendar in Notion that I use. It's how I plan my newsletters, my videos, my podcasts, even blog posts. And Notion's just so powerful because it's more than just a note-taking app. It actually allows you to make these like databases. So I have this big table in my content calendar, and it's got every possible thing I could want to put in here. The type of video, a status for them, little checkboxes, publish date, podcast number, all that's customizable, and then you can view it different ways. So I can say with videos, I'm working on a video right now, I can jump into Notion and I can have it viewed as only the videos, as like a Kanban board. And so here's the video I'm working on, my favorite productivity apps. And within here, I have all my research, my titles, the hook, the intro, even the whole script that I'm talking through right now. Everything is in one place, and it moves around through each stage of the process. And then when I want to schedule it, I can actually see it on my calendar. How cool is that? So here's just like a simple page in Notion. And you can do a lot of stuff with here, these little slash commands. I can put another page within here, you know, so that just created a whole nother page. I can do a to-do, so get milk. I can build a database. So remember I said I wanted to do like a table or something? I can put an inline table here and start to add properties to it if I want to. It's amazing. So like I can do a heading. I can write some stuff, which looks super nice. I can throw a bullet list in here. And each of these things I can drag and drop. All of this is all in one space. So you can see how you could build this out into something really magnificent and organized. And this is what I tell people. If you want one all-in-one productivity app, something that can do to-do lists, that can manage tasks, that can keep a calendar, anything you could possibly throw at it, Notion is that one do-it-all app. It's web-based, so no matter what you're on, you can use it. I really like Notion. I use it every day. And here's the huge bonus. It's completely free. Definitely, if you are interested in a note-taking app or like a project management type thing that's super clean and nice looking, Notion.so, check it out. The next app that I use every single day is Alfred. So Alfred is a Mac app, and it's a app launcher. So it's a more powerful spotlight bar. So you know on the Mac, you can click this little magnifying glass and you can kind of search for stuff. Alfred is basically that, but supercharged times maybe a million. And so I can, of course, open things in here. So I can open up GarageBand, which is already open and recording the audio for this right now. You can do file searches. So what if I wanted to find that self-portrait that I drew the other day? There it is. I can open it up in preview, or I can open it in Finder if I hit Command. I can do quick math equations in here. What's 5 times 5? 25. If I hit enter, that's going to copy that to my clipboard and I can paste it somewhere. It has clipboard history, so you can see all the stuff you've copied and pasted, not just one level of clipboard, you know, where it gets replaced. You can go back through time. Snippets, you can do the sort of autocomplete things that you save in here. So like I have different daily plan things. Sometimes I'll have at different times addresses or you know, common responses to emails that I save in here. But what I really, really like about it is the workflows. I have built out several different custom workflows that help me to quickly do repetitive tasks. So most of them are Apple scripts, but I can trigger them because Alfred is doing the work for me. So I use Accordance Bible software a lot, and I have a custom function in Alfred that allows me to paste in any kind of Bible text I want. So I can quickly type in ESV, 1 Peter 2, 1, it, boom, paste that right in line from Accordance Bible software. So a lot of stuff like that. It's just a really powerful tool. If you do get Alfred, you want to get the Power Pack. That's what enables you to do a lot of these custom things. They have a whole library of custom workflows that people have made that you can download and use that work with things like Spotify or really any app you can possibly think of has some sort of custom workflow for Alfred. So it's really powerful. I use it every day. It is a productivity booster for sure because it keeps me on the keyboard, which is going to make you a lot more efficient. The next app that I use every day is email. Well, specifically, I use Spark Email. So there are a lot of email clients out there, and some of them have a ton of bells and whistles, and some of them are really simple. I like Spark because it's a nice balance between a fairly simple email client, but has some killer features that make your email much more productive, in my opinion. So it's free, which is nuts. That's really awesome. So it's definitely worth trying, but it really allows you to have a lot cleaner inbox. The killer feature in Spark, in my opinion, is how it sorts your email for you. It smartly can tell the difference between a newsletter and spam, of course, and real emails. And so real emails from real people rise to the top, and newsletters are sorted into their own folder automatically. I'm a big fan of email newsletters. In fact, I write an email newsletter, but I subscribe to a lot of newsletters that I actually read. So I like to have those sorted separately because when I open my inbox, usually I want to deal with the real people first. It has a lot of other really cool features too, but I just love the simplicity. I love the clean UI, and I use it on all my devices right now. So Spark Email, it's free. It's definitely an app I use every single day. So that is it. Those are the five apps that I use every single day. If you got some value out of this video, please don't forget to hit like, and I will include links to all of those apps in the description, so you should check them out, and I will see you here in the next video.